Hello, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Knuston Farm, where I've decided to plough all the fields again. Because why not? And I do mean all of them. As you saw at the... as you might have seen at the end of the sped up video, we have bought field 8. I think it was the sped up video I did that. We have field 8, that is our field now. And it's already been ploughed. I've done some ploughing off camera, as you can see. Field 8 is ploughed, and I'm working on field 7 now. Field 1 is yet to be ploughed. And the only reason I'm ploughing it is because it's putting some nutrients back into the ground and reducing the moisture, which is kind of what I want to do. And it probably sounds like a really silly thing to be saying, I want to reduce the moisture. But I do, because the rain has caused problems, and I need to spray herbicide on the, on these fields. Now, I don't think I'll actually be doing much in terms of fertilizing this time around, because the fields are more or less where they need to be in terms of NPK. In terms of PK they are, and the grass fields will be needing some love, I know that, but these crop fields, with the exception possibly of field 8 itself, are more or less where they need to be in terms of base nutrient levels. I can't find my... oh, I've got my book up there. I do have my book of nutrient requirements for everything. So, we'll be working from that again. No, I didn't tell you to join that line, did I? I told you to join this one. There you go. And I'll keep the headlands until last, because I'll keep the headlands until last. It's been pretty dull. I mean, I finished harvest and I've immediately gone into ploughing, because I want to get things done as quickly as I possibly can. I'll probably at this point be ploughing into the night a small bit. Now, the aim, of course, is to get everything done today. All the ploughing is going to be done today. I'm going to be doing cultivation tomorrow, and then seeding the next day. Now, just out of character real quick, I don't mean you'll be getting a, a video today of ploughing, a video tomorrow of cultivating all the fields, and a video the next day of seeding. No, I mean in-game days, when I talk about days. So, yeah, tomorrow's cultivation day, the day after that is seeding day, and I'll kind of work out the nutrients and herbicides and all that kind of stuff from there once I've decided what fields are getting what. Now, I have been told I should plant barley on the largest of my fields, which I think... I'm not 100% sure on this. I can check. This. Apparently I can't. Because... I didn't check... didn't tell course plate auto-generate. Edge courses, well done me. Crossplay isn't auto generating edge courses because I told it not to. So I can't tell you what my biggest field is. And short of driving around the map and getting edge courses for all three fields, I'm Not quite sure, but just looking at the map, it does look like... It does look like it's still Field 1. Which works into my plans fairly well. Now, I'm sure you're wondering, well, what are your plans? They're evil and genius. No. Field 1 is going to get, as per requests, Field 1 is getting barley. Field 7 here is going to be seeded in wheat. And Field 8 is going to be seeded in an annual grass that doesn't spread, so it won't like take up all the clob, all the sod, so it'll just kind of stick to where I've seeded it, and I can mow it as much as I want after that. And Field 8 really is just, I've just bought that to get extra grass in for the compost. That's the entire reason I have Field 8 at the moment. Obviously, in the longer term, Field 8 is going to be another field for crops. Because, well, this is a farm after all. And I'm kind of hoping, I'm not 100% sure on this, I'm kind of hoping I can get cows with the next, or at least start getting the equipment I need for cows. Now, I do have a trailed forage harvester. I've managed to come across one. It is a JF1060 ProTech. And out of character real quick, I know I tested two other ones, or another one. The reason I went with the JF, which was one I didn't test, is because it's using the NI modding base from 2013, which is pretty stable, and I believe the one that I downloaded is error-free. I didn't check the log. Please go into the line I've told you to go into this time. Yes, you did, well done. Kind of. But yeah, we got a JF1060. The shop has it. They've only got the one, but they know the suppliers. So if the one that's there at the moment gets sold off before we get there, they can order one in for me. It is 45,200 euro to buy, which means that we do need to do at least one more harvest of just purely compost grass before we can even think about silage. I keep forgetting to rotate the plough, well done to me. We need at least one more essentially compost harvest before we can do silage. However, this hopefully won't work. However, I believe we can use straw to make compost and kind of dilute the grass and the compost. And the guys don't really notice because the straw rots just as well, and you know, the compost is just, it gives us the same benefits, it's just a bit cheaper to make, essentially. I know it is free to make, but with grass, I'm putting all of the grass into composting. With straw, yes, I'm putting all the straw into composting, but with straw you also get a crop of grains. So, you know, that kind of pays twice then, which is kind of the aim, is not necessarily to be really stingy and never spend on anything. No, I'm going to spend on what I can and kind of aim for the time being, at least, crops that can do double duty, essentially. The sugar beets, while they don't do double duty as such, their yield is so high that it's actually worth just doing a single duty crop of sugar beets. whereas wheat and barley, they produce straw, which means I get the crop to sell and the straw to compost down, so I get, more than double the money from what I would otherwise. Because otherwise I'd just be selling the straw off, and straw is not expensive to sell. straw is a very cheap thing to sell. It's so abundant around here because everybody does arable, and nobody else seems to have caught the composting as a good way to make money, which is fine by me. I mean, I'm not going to complain if I get to make all of the compost money, because I'm the only guy actually producing it. That's everybody else's problem, not mine. For some reason, the GPS didn't lock on. Me making all the compost money is everybody else's problem. My problem is getting grass to make compost. And equipment to speed things up, because up until now I've been kind of working a bit slowly for my liking. So the treble mowers, which can fit onto this New Holland, as well as the dual rotor wind rower, which I think I might be able to pull with the Massey, just for a bit of comedy. If I can get that thing to work on the back of the Massey, I'm putting it on the back of the Massey, just to see a Massey 690 series running a dual rotor wind rower. It does help if I shift the shuttle into forwards, doesn't it? What else am I planning to do on the farm? Good lord, I've got so much in my head. Obviously I'm planning on doing compost. I'm also planning on doing silage and selling at the BGA, the local biogas plant. Now that won't bring as much money as compost. However, that does do double duty, because, and this is where the double duty crops come back into it. Because if I'm not getting as much from, I just won't get as much from the BGA, from selling biogas, or yes, running the biogas plant, as I do from selling compost. That I know already. The thing is, though, if I were to buy a slurry spreader and make biogas, I could use the effluent from the biogas production to fertilize my fields as slurry. Whereas, yes, I could use the compost to fertilize my fields as well, but that means I can't sell it. Producing the biogas means that I can sell what amounts to silage. It just runs off silage and it gets digested in the plant, and there is an effluent left behind of various bacteria and unwanted nutrients. Unwanted by the bacteria and, unused or produced by the bacteria or whatever. And they usually are good nutrients to be throwing on the ground. So if I can get the equipment to start biogas production, which is going to be fun, because I'm going to essentially have to have two tractors on the go at once, but only use one at any given time, because I can't, in theory I can't run two at once. Actually, I know in practice I can't. There is a way I could, actually. I just remembered. I may do that. But the nitty gritty of it all, and the real proper true bottom line is, I like making the compost. It's easy to make, it's good to make. Biogas will get me more, because biogas will get me slurry, which is free fertilizer, and that's a good thing to have. So, you know, slurry, I get free fertilizer, which means I get... Yeah, I'm selling off grass, essentially. I have to leave fermented silage first. I'm essentially selling grass, which... It's grass. It grows freaking everywhere. I'm turning it into silage, which I could feed to animals, but I could sell it as well, and I'm going to sell it at the biogas plant. That's going to then produce energy for the local area, which the electricity company is going to pay me for, which is how I'm selling the silage at the biogas plant. I put the silage in, the electricity company pays me for the electricity I'm producing for them. Because I know it makes biogas, which is technically used for as a fuel. They do have a generator down at the local power plant that can use bioethanol, which is what a biogas plant produces. It won't make particularly good bioethanol because I'll be using grass, but it'll make bioethanol good enough that it can be used to power a generator, it can be used to make electricity that the electricity company can pay me for, so that I'll be getting money out of it. And then I'll be getting the effluent out of the tanks and using it as slurry on top of that. So it all works in my favor, and I could potentially just grow corn as well, which I can then sell, you know, 50% to the electricity company and sell off some as fuel for ethanol powered cars, of which there are not many, which is kind of why I'm more inclined to just do grass silage. I know cattle prefer grass silage as well, which is kind of an extra reason to do grass silage. But yeah. So we are coming up on halfway through this field now. And I know I've just been talking about plans for the future. Realistically, ploughing is not the most entertaining thing in the world to do. Especially not when I've got a GPS module running. Like, all I'm doing is turning off the GPS at the end of the field, raising the implement and turning around so that I can turn the GPS module back on. Much like that. And there we're going again. Got my foot to the floor. Not actually doing anything. What else did I do off camera? I did mow some of the grass down by where the cows are going to go in. The reason I haven't got cows yet, number one, I can't afford them. Number two, I'm just leaving all the buildings down there bed in, and because they are new buildings, I do want to just make sure they're all bedded in correctly and there's no subsidence issues that I should get worried about in the next little while. Once we can afford the cows, I'll be more than happy to start off work there. I'd be even happier if it turns out there's no subsidence issues or issues with the ground, because the buildings, you know, had to dig foundations, whatever. Well, I didn't, the builders did. And, that's a minor concern of mine, I guess. But, fingers crossed, all should be good. And, once we get the equipment in, because we do need quite a bit of investment to get cows running fully. It's going to take probably 100,000 to 200,000 to get the cows running as well as I want them to, because I'm gonna want about 100 head, there or thereabouts. And I know I've already got a round baler that I could use for straw. I want to feed them. I want to use square bales of straw. Well, square bales of hay, and some squares of straw for mixed ration production. Now, I also know, so don't get complaining about this, because I already know this, Also, now I could just get a bale wrapper and produce silage right now. If I really wanted to get silage going. Thing is, I'm not really too pressed on the whole silage production thing. And, it's a lot easier to cart around trailers full of silage than trailers full of bales full of silage. So, that's why I'm going for the chopped grass option. I may go... It really depends. If I only need a small bit of silage, as in 20 or 30 bales worth, which is what? 80 to 120,000 liters of silage per year. Yeah, I might just start making bale silage in the near future. However, I'm not going to go with a separate bale wrapper. I will be getting, if I do go with bale silage, I will be getting a McHale Fusion, because I have a cousin that works down at McHale Factory and I want to support, I want to keep him in a job. I know they had a fire last year, and things are a bit hectic there at the moment. It's just in character. I don't actually know anybody who works for McHale. Just as a disclaimer, I don't know anybody who works for an agricultural company other than, farmers. Which, yes, farms are agricultural companies, and I know that. I mean, an agricultural equipment company. Oh, nuts. That's precisely what I didn't want to do. Nope. More or less. So what I did there was I accidentally reset the GPS module, and now it's gonna potentially go off on a weird line here. I just wanted to be as... I think I've managed to reset it again to where it should be. Or at least close enough so that it doesn't make much of a difference. So the long-term plans here are to get, obviously, more fields, more of everything. And try and start off a proper... farm company. Right now it's just essentially just a small farm. I know we have some equipment that normally only contractors have, like a combine harvester and like the mower set, but we are kind of sharing them with the neighbors. We're giving them out on loan every so often and whatnot. I just don't show that bit of it. The neighbours are using our combine, which, yes, it's old, but it works. The mowers, we send off to the neighbours. They've got a Fendt of some description that can run them. And we don't really need any of their equipment, so... Because they're all small-time, they're all a lot smaller than us. Despite the fact that this farm isn't exactly big. They're all family-run farms. This is... is technically a business, although it is being run like a family farm. Couldn't get the GPS to engage there. This farm is technically a business. I mean, you see the size of the yard, it should be a business, it is becoming a business, and I think, I won't do it now, but I think once I've got the ploughing done, what I'll do is I'll put all the equipment into sheds, because there is some rain forecast. Well, the weather's been a bit predictably unpredictable. Is that a thing? The weather's been completely unreliable of late, so I want to try and get... Well, I want to put all the equipment into sheds. Oh, for the love of... Come on. Nope, too far. Too far that way. That... Nope. There. GPS is kind of after getting a mind of its own, apparently. The weather has been predictably unpredictable. There's been a lot of storms, a lot of flooding. We've escaped it, luckily. I don't know how, but we have. GPS, I told you to go on, not just switch yourself off at random. I don't know what's going on today, but technology apparently hates me. We've escaped the flooding so far. Now, if there is a flood, we're screwed because all our fields will be underwater. Most of them, anyway. All the grass fields will be. And they're kind of our bread and butter at the moment, so... You know, if they go under, the farm is essentially dead. Because if the grass fields go under, I will pretty much be forced, because all the grass will die off, I'll pretty much be forced to plough them up and replant the grass. That's something I want to avoid. I know I could leave the grass grow back on its own, but it would take so long to recover to where it's healthy enough that I can, you know, produce from it, that I would just prefer to go in there with a plough and a cedar. Because the Vaderstad cedar we have is direct drill, so we can... If I really wanted to, I could seed directly onto this ploughed bed. It, you know, the cedar produces its own seed bed, which... You know, I may just seed directly onto the ploughed ground. For cultivating, but I know I don't have to. I will cultivate after every harvest, though. But the ploughing itself is breaking up. Ploughing is breaking up the sod, so I could, in theory, I may skip cultivation and just go straight to seeding, because that is a direct drill seeder. Yeah, I think I'm gonna do that. And that knocks one problem out of the way. Realistically, I forgot to flip the plough again. I'm being very cautious with how I'm dealing with the GPS module now, because it is in a bit of a mood, apparently. So, we are almost out of time. We've only got a couple of minutes left in this video. I know it hasn't been the most entertaining, and I've essentially just been detailing plans and fears. Fear and loathing in Las Vegas, whatever. Which I really need to watch. I've been told it's a brilliant movie, and I've never watched it. I know it's based on a book, but I've heard the movie of Johnny Depp is very good. Not suitable for children, might I add, but I've heard the movie is very good. So I may watch it at some point. If I can get my hands on it. I think if I seed wheat and barley, just going back to planning again, if I seed wheat and barley and... can make compost out of the straw. Obviously I will, if I can. What I will do, or what I can do then, is skip ploughing for a while. Because I'd essentially be working off a field with no additional nutrients. This field, as you can probably see if I just drive in over here a bit, is gaining some nutrients, I believe, from me plowing this under. It may not be. I may just be making a mistake here and thinking that the sugar beet leaves are giving me extra nutrients, but in fact they're not. But I think it's a good idea to plough the leaves in anyway, because it might not give you extra nutrients, but it's better. It's going to be a better ground to seed in. They'll be rotting underground, and worms and stuff come and improve the soil and make their own natural compost. Just to make the soil a bit softer. Because I have noticed that it's not particularly noticeable in videos, obviously. The soil here is rather hard, no matter what I do, no matter how often I plow it. It's just hard soil that feels like it's always compacted. Getting what are essentially useless bits of ground in, useless bits of plant, I guess, getting them in is not necessarily a terrible idea. They may bring worms in. They should bring worms and bacteria and whatever in to hopefully soften up the soil a small bit. That's the hope, at least. Whether that happens is a different matter. Anyway, I am going to continue ploughing, obviously. And I'll be back next time, in a couple of days for you, with some sped up ploughing. And then I'll take a short break for a couple of weeks. You've got all your videos for a while now. It's not even Christmas for me yet. You've got all your videos for a while. I'll come back and I will start seeding. In a while. I know it's going to just seem like a single day has passed. Or perhaps even no time at all. But I'm going to take a break for Christmas and all of that stuff. And leave the ground ploughed over the Christmas period to hopefully, because I know there's a lot of storms coming, hopefully soften up a bit and hopefully not too much moisture, but get softened up and loosened up. So until then, and by the way, that was all just in character. I'm recording this on January, where's my watch? 10th. I know that sounded like a weird question, where's my watch? I don't have a smartwatch, before anybody asks. It's a dumb watch. It's an analog watch that just has a date instead of the 3. Which is helpful. I mean, it's always good to have a watch where you can just check the date as well as the time. Anyway, until next time, when we will be speed ploughing by request of... I've forgotten who requested it, but it was requested. This bit wasn't, but the speed ploughing was, so deal with it. Until then, stay safe, and goodbye.